Hello guys and welcome to Destro Gaming. Today we are going to discuss the new trader class. So the first thing, let's see how you become a trader. So I'm right now in the room where I can choose a class. And here is the trader class. It's a stick next to the doctor class. So previously this was a traveler. And now it is a trader. So the traveler didn't have any purpose besides role-playing. Now this trader has some purpose. So let's see what we can do with this trader class. Now, first thing I want to mention is that the trader class cannot fight, doesn't have good fighting skills, but it has a good riding skill. So you're quite fast with the horse. And I recommend to buy the fastest horse as possible. This is the one with 48 speed. I'm just checking to be sure. I am a bit tempted to get the camel, but yeah, the camel is a bit slower, but and it will draw too much attention. So I think it's just better to get the fastest horse possible here, so we don't have any trouble. Yeah, it's hard decision, but yeah, I got the horse finally. And what we can do with this class, we can go to the outside most of the castles, there is a trading center. Like this tent here, you can see that it has trading goods. These are materials that have no value for crafting. But these are trading materials for only for trader class. I think the other classes can buy them too, but the trader class can check the prices. You see me now doing exactly that. I'm checking the prices. So what does it tell me? It tells me when it is green. It tells me that on this occasion I'm going to make some profit. So what I'm noticing? I'm noticing that on this Doris Danach castle I can make profit. So what are we gonna do? Let's do one run to this castle to see how this works. And we are back. We are now running to the castle. First we are going to the bank. We need to be able to trade. You need a lot of money. You'll make some profit with less money, but especially when their prices are very close to each other, you need a lot of money to make actually the profit. And the other thing is that there is a withdrawal tax rate of 10%. So every time you withdraw money from the bank, you pay 10%. So keep in mind that if you want to make profit, you have to make more than 10% to actually be worth it. So this is me right now. I'm going to get some money. I'm gonna get like 200k. Yeah, so I'm typing more because there is, as I mentioned, there is 10%. So right now I got less money than that what I typed actually, because there is the tax. So now we are running back. What is our goal now? We have to take the cheaper goods, the cheaper trade goods, and go to the other trading center where they are. So buy low, sell high. So we go to the cheaper goods, buy them, spend all our money, and then we go to the most expensive place that we can find and sell the goods. So this is how we make profit. We make profit of these margins of the trading goods. But also what you need to consider. You need to consider that there is a high risk in this job, because you're carrying around, as you can see, I'm carrying around 200k gold. And if I get killed, I'm gonna drop 25% of my gold. So I'm just spending all my money here. And this will be an easy run for me, because the best price I have is the castle that is very close to me. So right now I'm going to this castle to sell the goods. And You have to be careful because nowadays in this new release also the outlaws, the bandits, they can halt you for your inventory, so they can steal the trading goods from you. So it is very important, and you can see me, I saw some enemies there. I'm not sure what is the situation, are they friendly, are they not friendly, because when I sell, when they see me sell the goods, I will have a lot of money. And it is this is a bit of a risky business, guys. But I finally decided that I will go and sell. I think that they are not doing anything, just talking and messing around. Yeah, so this is the trading center. I'm selling everything. And I have to run. I'm running back to the bank to deposit. So what we made, actually, we made like 11k or something, but with the tax rate, I'm not sure that this is very profitable run, because I already paid 10% of my withdrawal. So I'm not sure that this was actually very profitable, maybe a little bit, but I just wanted guys to show you how the trading is working. Obviously, when the price difference is higher, you can make really big money. Right now, what I did was not very profitable, but it was very easy run. And it was just an example how you can make money with the trader class. Now, if you want to make a lot of money, you have to risk more. Because you will have to, let's say, keep the money in you without withdrawing all the time. So you make 5, 6 to 10 runs and then you deposit. So you make like 100k profit and then you deposit. But it is a bit risky because, as I said, you can get halted. You are carrying around a big portion of your wealth and you are risking this 25%. But this is how the trader class works. Now let's check the map and see what are the location of each trading center and banks. Okay guys, here is the map. Now let's see the locations of each trading center. We are going to mark them so we can see what options do we have and what routes we can make on the map. So first, this is our starting castle. For me, this is Nazir Castle. I'm marking the trading location. This is the Doris Danach Castle. What we have else as option? We have option for Montimor Castle. This is the Kirut Castle. Usually the trading location is just outside the castle. It's like impossible to miss it. So what we have next? We have Richfield here. Torvik City we have here. You have to enter inside. For the Richfield, I haven't been to the trading, so I'm not sure. Here is the Fortuna Stronghold. And now let's check where there are three banks on the map. This is one of the first bank is right next to the trading center, which is good. Here is the location of the second bank. And the third bank, I am not sure, but I think that it is in Valius Village. But you can correct me in the comments if I'm mistaken here. But I think here is the location of the third bank. So what we actually did in the previous run? What was our run? Let's we forgot Vorsik Castle. Here it is, the last trading point. So as you can see, these trading points are spread around the map. So you need to find like the best routes, the safer routes. So this is what we did now. We went to the bank from Nazir Castle. We withdrew our money. This was our first action. Then we went back to Nazir Castle and we bought the trading goods on cheaper price. This was our 20th action and we went to Doris Danach or whatever it's called and we sold our goods. So we had a lot of money, so we went to the bank. Now this is not very profitable because paying this tax 10%, it's not very good. So you to make really good profits, you need to make a lot of runs, like up to 5-10 runs to make some good profit. But it is, as I mentioned, it is risky. Now let's see what other routes we have. So the first one is from Nazir to Torvik, but this is only by boat. Then we can continue to Kirut Castle here. The other route is here next to the Merc camp. You pass and there is a bridge and you can go to Fortuna. Then from Fortuna, you have a passage that leads to Torvik. And then, of course, you can go through the swamps and go to Richfield. I'm not very big fan of Richfield because you have to pass some stairs. It's very, you can get halted. And yeah, this route here is only by boat. If you have a boat, you can make this very easy from Nazir to Torvik. So yeah, this is how it looks. The trading class is, it's very interesting. I can say, and yeah. If you like this video, guys, if you like my explanation of this class, please subscribe to this channel. I'm going to make a lot of videos on PE, like funny content, fights, guides, everything related to PE. So thank you very much for your attention today, for watching this video, and see you on the battlefield. Bye-bye.